tonight I just wanted to do a quick review and show some sample images of the Viltrox 23mm f1.4 lens. Now, if you're looking at this video, you've already heard about that lens, and bottom line, is it as good as all the other reviews are saying? And the answer is yes, it's a very good lens. The reason why I wanted one is I didn't want to spend the $899 Fuji is asking for their own 23mm f1.4 lens. I had one years ago when the X-T1 was brand new, and while it was a good lens, it probably wasn't the best 35mm focal length I ever used. So then I went ahead and got the 23mm f2.0 years later, and it's a decent lens, but focusing up close, it's horrible. There's no excuse for it to be that bad. So when the Viltrox came out and I was hearing all sorts of great reviews, for the price, I figured definitely worth picking one up and taking a shot on it. So right now I'm shooting this video with the Viltrox 23mm f1.4 on the Fuji X-T4, and you can see it's autofocusing just fine. Typical tests just to see how well it focuses. Focus is great. Now, fast, but everything's fast on the X-T4. So I don't have any complaints from a video standpoint. I'm shooting this at f1.8 at 60 frames per second. Now, one really cool thing about this lens is you can update the firmware without having to have a dock like you do from some of the other lens manufacturers, like Tamron or Sigma. If you want to update the firmware on those lenses, you have to have a separate adapter that they charge you for, which I thought was ridiculous. This lens by the lens mount actually has a micro USB plug. You just plug your cable right into it and update the firmware that way. I think that's genius. The lens hood, it's nice. It's better than the Fuji ones. It's metal. The lens feels nice in the hand. It's a little light, but once it's on the camera, feels great. I like the aperturing. I thought the clickless aperture would really bother me, but when you are going through the lens and it's mounted to the camera, you hear kind of a click on the inside. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but it does have hard stops just without the clicking, if that makes sense. It's really not an issue, and the lens registers just fine on the camera. There's no issues there. Focusing is wonderful. I had no problem using it today, and so far, really impressed with the lens. Let's go ahead and take a look at some pictures. These are going to be straight out of the camera. The only thing I did do was in Photo Mechanic, I was able to resave the images with the aperture basically watermarked onto the image. And the reason why I did that just makes it easier to look at things and talk about it. So let's go ahead and switch over to that. Okay, so this is just not in any particular order other than chronologically. When I first got the lens, it was not the nicest of days, and rather than just wait to shoot with the lens, I figured I'll just take pictures of what I can indoors. So this is in low light, focuses on the cat. Of course, the first image I'm going to show is a cat picture. Why wouldn't I? Now here, the focus is on the RX bar on the bottom right-hand side. Just zoom in. Now at F2, that is pretty darn sharp. I don't really have any issues with that. Definitely sharper than the Fuji 23mm f2. What I don't like about this lens is that's as close as I could get. I would have liked to have got closer. So that's probably the only disadvantage of this lens. The other disadvantage is it's not weather sealed, but that's not really an issue, which I'll talk about later on. But today we were out there in the pouring rain. I used this cover, which I've talked about before, a company by the name of Photosharp, F-O-T-O-S-H-A-R-P. Has these nylon bags, and it's a absolute essential saver. Use the lens hood, use that, and there's no issue. Now, this is just in my kitchen. I wanted to get closer. This is as close as I could get to the toast. Now, is this a great shot? No, but what we're looking for here is sharpness at f1.4. And so, center of the frame, pretty stinking sharp. And again, I couldn't get as close as I wanted. Let's go into some more exciting photos. Now at F8, this was out at a place called the Nisqually National Wildlife Refuge down by Olympia, Washington. Plenty sharp at F8. And again, these are straight out of the camera. So this is f9. What you see here is it's perfectly sharp. Is this the sharpest lens for Fuji? You have to understand it's a crop sensor. So I think this is fine for any lens. And at f9, there's zero issues. So we just see how sharp it is up front, up close. Nice. Let's go to something a little more exciting. Plenty of detail in the shot. This is just a nice landscape shot, or I like it. And what you're going to see here is that plenty of sharpness throughout the frame at f8, no issues. Now at f1.4, what I really like about this lens, and not to sound corny, but it definitely does give you a 3D pop feel. So let's look at that leaflet right here in the middle. Focus is right here, and you can see the background melts away quite nicely. Is it the smoothest bokeh? I don't know. It's kind of busy, but again, it's a $329 lens, and I think this is perfectly acceptable. I would not recommend the Fuji for $900. No, not a chance. Again, f1.4, you can see the background just kind of melt away. Plenty of sharp at 1.6, and this is the corner of the frame. Focus was on our eye. I didn't use the eye detect. I manually set the focus point. Now here's 2.8. Plenty of sharp right there in the eyes. You can even see the food that my daughter had stuck in her teeth. And that's in every shot today. I don't know what she was eating, but it's in all the shots. Really like how sharp it is at f1.4. Making the background is just really nice and melts away. Now, this is a shot I would have liked to have been able to get closer, and I wasn't able to. This was as close as I could get to that frog. Now, it's a little soft, but it's not the center of the frame, and not bad at all. Again, f1.4, droplets of water here in the middle are quite nice. The leaf is sharp enough. Busy bokeh, but it was a busy background. At 3.6, plenty of detail. And again, this is straight out of the camera. Once you're shooting things like f13, there was zero issue. I mean, this is plenty of sharp. I think it's only limited by the sensor at this point. By the way, the Fuji X-T4, great camera, best Fuji I've ever used. And with this lens, it's a fantastic combo. Here's another example of why I would have liked to have been able to get closer. This was as close as I could get to the broken glass without it being out of focus. And then here we are, nice portrait at f1.4, focus right here on her eye. Plenty of detail, nice portrait lens. No issues there. And it did well keeping with autofocus. I mean, it worked as well as any lens I would have liked. Now, I would have liked to have spent some more time trying to get that shot right. I don't know if that was me or the lens. I'm going to blame myself on that one. But here we go at f1.4. Look at the detail there on the wheat. I don't think it's wheat, but whatever that is. Great landscape lens. And even at f1.4 on a landscape, able to get one place in focus and the rest kind of just get soft. Now, there is some vignetting. I actually like vignetting. It doesn't bother me at all. It adds something to the picture. Here's another one at f1.4. Focus is right about here. And I don't find it unpleasing at all. F8 plenty sharp. Now here's f1.4 in bad light. And you're even able to see the little birdie up here in the left-hand side of the frame. So not quite center, but plenty sharp for f1.4. And again, for not a Fuji branded lens, this is just fine. Let's just see if there's anything else here. Okay, f2.2. Now this is off center of the frame, so to the right. Plenty of sharp on the eye. Nice detail on the skin. I have zero issues with this lens, guys. I can't recommend it highly enough. Now, I've read it doesn't work on an X-Pro 3 because it'll actually damage the camera. So don't use it on an X-Pro 3. Check the website. What we got here? We're at 1.4. Look at those eyes. Great job. Okay, now here's an example of trying to test the continuous autofocus with fast shutter in a shot like this. It started pouring on rain. I ran it farther ahead to grab a picture of my little girl. And okay, she's blurry. She's out of focus. But it looks like I did nail the focus on something. And perfectly great, perfectly fine, f1.4. No issues. Here's another one at f1.4 with my wife. She was walking, trying to get the rain. Great job. Even able to separate the water droplets. Perhaps I should have shot at a higher shutter speed, but the amount of detail you're getting in this, fantastic. Now, this is one shot where I'm going to think it has to be me because everything else looks pretty darn good. F4.5, I probably should have stopped down a little bit more. Shoes are in focus. Face is not as much as I would have liked. Now, it was wet. I probably wiped the lens with my shirt to dry it off. Or a lens cloth that I accidentally dropped and got some dirt on it from a fan. So I think did fine. 1.6, plenty sharp. And just trying to get the raindrops, f4. And here's a prime example of the vignetting, but I think for a shot like this, it works just fine. It gives you the focus right here in the middle, and then everything else just kind of melts away. That's it. So, should you get this lens? Yep. If you're interested in getting a 23 millimeter lens for Fuji, I would recommend this. I would recommend this over the Fuji 23 millimeter f2 lens, which I have here. I'm actually thinking maybe I should just sell this lens now. I'll keep it for a little bit longer just to compare the two. This is phenomenal. Now, which is the best 23 millimeter lens for Fuji? For that, I would have to say it's the X100V. And the reason why I say that, it lets you get very, very close. It's nice and compact. It's probably sharper than this lens or the other 23 millimeter f2. And here's kind of how you have to look at it. If the Fuji 23 millimeter is f1.4 is $900, for just a little bit more, you get a whole camera system and everything else in the X100V. The EVF is fantastic, great way to go. Now, granted, more expensive, but if you're on a budget or just want the best f1.4 23 millimeter lens, this is it. The Viltrox, hands down. Now, I haven't tried the 35 millimeter or 33 millimeter. Not sure what it is. It's an 85 as well. If they're as good as this lens, I'm going to pick those up without any issues, any concerns. Now, my recommendation, buy this through Amazon. I'll put an affiliate link in my down below and in the blog. So if you do want this lens, you buy it through Amazon, I'll get a little bit of a kickback. Basically, I don't do this for a living. It might help me offset the cost of my website. That's about it. So if you have any questions, please leave it below. And I'll post a link to my blog so you can see these pictures in a little more high resolution. All right, thanks for checking this out.